Okay, in the previous lecture, we developed these linearized longitudinal and lateral equations. And so let's just remind ourselves what we're looking at here. This is F equals ma, the top three equations here for each of these is F equals ma, and then the bottom three equations are for each of these are the kinematic transformation equations. And basically, what these equations are showing us is how the state of the aircraft is going to change with small disturbances about an equilibrium flight condition. And remember, we chose our equilibrium flight condition to be in steady flight. Now, this can be climbing flight, so we can have some non-zero theta. And so you see that theta not turn up here in several places. So we can have some non-zero climb angle, but we have zero bank angle, and we've aligned the aircraft, or the equilibrium state of the aircraft, so it's headed due north, because the dynamics of the aircraft shouldn't depend on the direction that it's facing. Okay, so we've also assumed that the aircraft has zero bank angle, and that it's perfectly symmetric. And that allowed a lot of the terms, the aerodynamic terms, as well as the inertia terms to drop out. So we just have the symmetric inertia terms, for example, that are left here. We have, so we're assumed that the aircraft is perfectly symmetric. The mass is distributed symmetrically about the XZ plane, and the aerodynamics are symmetric about the XZ plane. Okay, so at this point, we actually, for a given flight condition here, we know everything inside of these equations except for these derivatives. So we have a whole bunch of aerodynamic derivatives. Now remember, this is a pseudo aerodynamic force. This force includes the capital F here and the capital M are the force and moment that include not only the aerodynamics, so the pressure and viscous forces on the aircraft, but also the thrust. Any thrust is also included in those terms, okay? And so what we need here are derivatives of these forces and moments with respect to a few different parameters here. So for example, we need them with respect to U, V, and W. We also need them with respect to P, that's our roll rate, Q is our pitch rate, and R is our yaw rate. We also need them with respect to U dot, so that's an acceleration or a change in velocity in the U direction, a change in velocity in the W direction, and actually our V dot, so that's U dot and W dot. Our V dot, all of those dropped out for reasons explained in the previous video. So we don't have any derivatives with respect to V dot. And then finally, we also have derivatives with respect to our control deflections. So delta A, our aileron, delta E, our elevator, and delta R for the rudder, okay? So these are the derivatives that we need for these aerodynamic forces and moments on the aircraft. And we could put this aircraft in a wind tunnel or maybe have some really nice CFD solutions where we could just get each of these derivatives directly at this flight condition, at this equilibrium flight condition. The challenge is that we could do that, but that's not often done with aircraft. That takes quite a bit of work to get these derivatives using that method. And so what we usually do is, you know, we usually don't look at derivatives, aerodynamic derivatives, with respect to these parameters as we've written it here. Usually we look at derivatives with respect to alpha and beta and forward velocity. Now P, Q, and R, we actually do use those directly. And U dot and W dot, we're going to talk about those. And actually our control surface deflections, we'll talk about those in more detail in subsequent videos here. But basically we're going to walk through the methodology for estimating each of these derivatives using traditional aerodynamic forces and moments. Okay. So let's start off by writing traditional aerodynamic forces and moments on this aircraft. So for example, FXB, FYB, and FZB. So we usually write that as 1/2 rho V squared SW times a coefficient in each direction. So we'd have a coefficient in X, coefficient in y, coefficient in z. Those are aerodynamic force coefficients that do not include thrust. And so then we'd need to add the thrust term to that. So it'd be thrust times, now for our aircraft, again, we're gonna assume that the thrust is perfectly symmetric, but it could have some vertical offset relative to the center of gravity. And so, and also that thrust doesn't have to be aligned with the direction of flight. So the thrust vector is not necessarily perfectly aligned with the x-axis here, okay? So so the thrust in the x direction is going to be thrust times cosine times alpha t naught, and alpha t naught is that angle that that it's rotated relative to our x-axis. And the y direction at zero, because again, we're assuming that this aircraft is perfectly symmetric about the xz plane, including the thrust. And then in the z direction, we have minus sine alpha t naught. Okay, so those are our aerodynamic forces. And we can do the same thing for the moment. So we've got mxb, myb, mzb. So these are moments about the x, y, and z axes. Usually we write that in terms of 1/2 rho v squared sw times a moment coefficient. And so our moment coefficient about the x-axis is cl. We actually need to multiply that by the wingspan to get that, to dimensionalize that. And then cm about the y-axis, and that's multiplied by c bar w. And cn times bw is the moment about the z-axis. And then again, we can have the thrust. Now the thrust, because it's perfectly symmetric about the xz plane, it doesn't create any moments about the x and z axes, but it can create a pitching moment if we have a vertical offset. And so the top and bottom here will be zero, but the pitching moment is gonna depend on the z location of that thrust times cosine of alpha t naught plus the x location of the thrust times sine of alpha t naught. Okay, so that's the pitching moment caused by that thrust. And of course, for this to be an equilibrium state, the aerodynamic moment here has to be, the pitching moment from the aerodynamics has to be offsetting the aerodynamics from the thrust, or excuse me, the pitching moment from the thrust, okay? Okay, so let's look at a couple more of these parameters in a little bit more detail. So actually, Cx, Cy, and Cz, we seldom use those directly. Usually, we write Cx, Cy, and Cz in terms of lift and drag, okay? And so, so depending on the angle of attack of the aircraft, the force in the x direction is going to be CL times sine alpha minus CD cosine alpha. So this is simply a rotation in alpha. CY, we just call that CY for now, and we'll talk about derivatives of that with respect to different parameters. And then CZ is minus CL cosine alpha minus CD sine alpha. Okay, so usually we're talking about those forces, the x and the z directions, in terms of lift and drag. Now remember, at our equilibrium state, so let's say at equilibrium, we have our velocity vector u, v, and w is equal to v naught, 0, 0. Okay, so that's what we defined as our equilibrium state. We aligned our x-axis with our free stream velocity vector. And so that means that at equilibrium, alpha and beta are both 0, okay? And so when you plug that in here, at equilibrium, Cx is just equal to minus Cd, and Cz is equal to minus Cl, okay? But we want to be looking at small deviations about this, and so we're going to use alpha. Now, alpha just refers to the angle that our aircraft is deviating relative to our trim state there. Our aerodynamic angle of attack difference between our actual dynamic state and the trim state of the aircraft. Okay, so that's what alpha is going to refer to here. But at the trim state, both alpha and beta are zero. Okay, so that means that at the trim state, or at equilibrium, we can say that CX, CY, CZ, and then we can also look at CL, CM, and CN. These are our aerodynamic coefficients. At equilibrium, CX is minus CD, CY is zero, because we're saying that we have no side force on the aircraft at this equilibrium state, just by how we've defined it. And then CZ is minus CL, okay, at equilibrium. And the C subscript L, our rolling moment, is zero. We can have some pitching moment. We're just going to call that CM. We're used to calling that CM. And CN is zero, okay? So this is at equilibrium. These are our forces and moments on the aerodynamic forces and moments on the aircraft, okay? So we're now going to, just so you can see where we're going, what we're going to be doing now is coming up and looking at each of these derivatives that we need. So for example, we're going to start off with derivatives with respect to U, V, and W, all right? So we need to look at derivatives with respect to FXB, or of FXB with respect to U. So we're going to come down here and look at FXB. We're going to take the derivative of this equation with respect to U, and then we're going to evaluate that at the equilibrium condition. Okay, so that's why it's important for us to know what's happening at the equilibrium condition. These are those forces and moments, or the coefficients at equilibrium. All right, so that's where we're headed, and that's what's coming up here.